In the latest Twitch news, Twitch streamer Frogan has gone viral on social media after making continuous comments about the US military. In a recent livestream, clips of her hit Twitter X in which she exclaimed that she had no pity for the soldiers and received a ton of backlash from the community and other streamers. Here is the clip.
I have no pity at all for any soldiers. I will never have any pity for any soldiers. US military? Boo fucking who? I hope you get PTSD.
The ones I'm like whatever about, the US soldiers, are the ones that like acknowledge that like what they did was wrong. They didn't know back then. Whatever. You're a good person in my book. The US military that are like, yeah, like, you know, I did this back then, but now I know it's wrong, like I'm changed, like imperialism, this, you don't deserve the PTSD. But like any other, you're joining them, you're like, oh my god, I want my Camaro, no student loans. I hope you get PTSD, and I hope you get no health insurance when you get back into America.
Part of Twitch streamer FR Zirogan proclaims that she hopes all American soldiers die or get PTSD. She truly is disgusting. Amazon runs Twitch, and Twitch frequently promotes her in ads. I have pity for Frogan's fridge. She probably gets PTSD from seeing a diet soda. Shez pisses me off. Look, there's still so many of us in the streaming world that appreciate our veterans and those that serve this country. Thank you for our freedoms. We're grateful for our privilege. Hassan's mod and Twitch streamer Frogan doubles down on the horrendous things she said about American troops.
I hope you get PTSD. And I hope you get no health insurance when you get back into fucking America. And they posted it in my head. I'm like, base? Like, am I supposed to be like, I'm not walking back on it. I still agree with it. Base?
After this blew up all over social media, she then apologized in the following tweet.
The US military has conducted some of the most horrific crimes against humanity in the modern era in countries such as Iraq, Afghanistan, Syria, Lebanon, and Palestine. My anger is directed at individuals who are currently championing these war crimes as if they liberated my people. It's horrific and disgusting. The beginning of the clip was worded poorly, and I do apologize for that. I go on to clarify in the clip that I do not mean all military, but specifically those with no remorse. What I said was out of frustration, as they are currently bombing my family in the name of liberation. I realize that wishing people harm isn't the best way to talk about these issues, and that I could have talked about these topics in a more sensitive way.
After Frogan's comments, Aidan Ross shared his thoughts in a recent controversy involving Frogan, where she expressed that she hoped the soldiers surviving in the US military developed PTSD. Here is Aidan Ross on Frogan.
I speak for what's right. This is wrong to say that US soldiers who fight every single day for America to say they deserve PTSD. This girl's a terrorist. Get her out of America. Listen to this shit.
Any other motherfucker, I hope you get PTSD.
Stuff your face, you fat pig.
When you get back in.
Disgusting pig, bro. Holy shit.
Base?
Dirty fat animal. Disgusting.
Serious medical condition, veteran status. This is their own toes. Twitch bans people for absolutely ridiculous tiny mischiefs all the time. How is she still allowed to be there? Is she going to be banned like Asmongold, who simply said that he doesn't care about Palestine and that their laws are inferior because they stoke women? One of the most evil things I've heard on at Twitch then, she proceeds to say, OMG, thank you for the 10 gifted crazy times.
Destiny uncovers the real reason why he remains banned on Twitch.
I'm sorry. I can be conspiratorial. You ready, Dan? You ready for a big one?
Go ahead. I'm ready.
What if one of the big reasons why they didn't unban me is because I'm so pro-Israeli that if they unbanned me and a whole bunch of Israelis tried to make an account on the site, that it would be uncovered immediately if there was that country ban?
There's no way, bro. Because if
I was unbanned, it would have been uncovered it like on day two, right? You know that it would have been almost
day
immediate,
two.
Right?
It actually would have. You're not wrong. You're actually not wrong.
I'm being anti-Semitically targeted now, okay?
Dude, you're so...
What the...
You put it away, bro.
And wait, you think this is like...
Wait, hold on. Just to be clear. Irrelevant. That conspiracy
sense.
That I just alleged is less crazy than what has actually happened. That wouldn't even be...
I don't know what's happening.
That is
true.
Yeah, no matter how you feel about the guy, it's kind of nuts that Destiny is still banned when you see the people that are being allowed back on the platform. Like, Holocaust-denying schizo red pillars are less controversial somehow? LOL, I watch Destiny and disagree with the reason why he was banned in the first place, but it's not surprising at all he has not been unbanned. His podcast co-host, with Destiny co-signing these comments, has been campaigning against Twitch's CEO for a long time now. I know Dan thinks this is somehow the path to getting Destiny unbanned, but it has done exactly the opposite. What company would unban someone that religiously attacks its CEO? I mean, Dan made an entire website called Dan Clancy Sucks. No shot Twitch is unbanning him ever. I could be wrong on the details, but Destiny's ban predates Dan Clancy becoming CEO and had multiple appeals denied within a matter of minutes, IIRC, before Dan started his crusade. Twitch was never giving any serious consideration.
Twitch unbans Houthi terrorist after not even 12 hours on Twitch.
Oof, oh my god. Tal. Rakam wahed. Number one. Number one. Tal. Rakam wahed. Number one.
Toad made an ALT to ban Evade, and he still gets unbanned. Twitch Lemo, Nick Fuentes unbanned next. They're assembling the anti-Semitism Avengers. They got Sneeko, Myron, and Hyothi Terrorist. Just Nick left, and Dan Clancy about to bust a harder nut than when he watches those Kuma streams. It's really horrible that the fact that Sneeko shouted down with the Yahood, live on Twitch, didn't do to him. From what I also gathered, Ethan Klein has a huge issue with Israel, but braindead people on Twitch began calling him a Zionist and ridiculing him because he felt sympathy for Okt. Seventh, and he very somewhat supports Israel, right for self-defense. That granted him that on an official live from Twitch, they rated streamers, with the top being Arab and the bottom Sabra lover. Sabra is a nickname for Israelis, though it's more correct that it's a nickname for an Israeli born in Israel, but whatever. Idiots. The crowd booed when they thought of where to put him. Then one of the people on stage said something like, oh, we missed something down there, a Zionist. This is from an official stream from Twitch. They publicly ridicule people who show some sympathy for the massacre of October 7th. Also, companies like Samsung sponsored that event. Horrible.